How y'all doing? This is Aristotle, and I'll be going over a quick introduction on how I set up my chart from start to finish. So, these will all be personal preferences, and I'm just going to show you guys how I overall set up my whole chart and my thought process. So, the first thing I'm going to do is click on Profile. You'll see that on the bottom right-hand corner. Then I'll go to Settings, that gear in the top right-hand corner. Then I'll go to dark theme. So this is how I like it. So I'll click that. So now we're on a dark theme. So I'll click charts, which is on the bottom to the left. Now I'm on a dark theme. So the first thing I want to do is set up my indicator. So the first thing I'm going to do is next to that clock thing on the top right hand side, it's a little toggle, press that. I'm going to go to indicators. Then I'm going to go to built-ins. And I'm going to find moving average. So I'm going to click that one. As you can see, it popped up on the left-hand side. Two, three, four. So I have my 8, 21, 50, 200. Perfect. Okay. So now, I like my 8 to be my fast moving average. Now remember, I'm using moving average simples, not EMAs, which is exponential moving average, but just regular moving average. So I want to click the gear right here on the top left hand side. I want to click the gear. And then I'm going, this is just personal preference. I want them to be green because that equals fast to me, right? So, and then I want them to be a little thicker. So, bam, I have my 8-day moving average, which is going to be green, right? And I'm going to set that length to 8. So, bam, 8-day moving average, right? Then I'm going to go to the second one. And I'm going to length this one to 21-day moving average, which is my medium-term moving average. And I'm going to set this color to, what I like it, yellow, right? Because I think yellow and green go hand in hand. I'm going to make that one a little thicker. You know what? I'll keep it medium. I can still see it. Next, I want my 50-day moving average. So click the gear, type in 50. And then I want this moving average to be thicker. And I wanted this purple down here that I created through the little color scheme. So I want that one to be very visible because that's an important MA, right? So bam, I have my 50, 8, 21, and 50-day moving average. And I'm going to go to the heart and soul of all moving averages, which is the 200-day moving average. And I want this one to be very visible and thick as possible. So I'm going to go with this orange color. Going to make it very visible. And I'm going to change how I want it to look. So I want it to look kind of, nah, not that one. Let's see, this one. Yep, bam. So that's my 200-day moving average, which is very visible. All of my moving averages are visible. I color scheme these for a reason. Because the 8-day moving average is fast, so it represents green to me. The yellow moving average, which is my 21-day moving average, is my medium-term moving average, so I want it to be yellow. Kind of like the red light, green light system. But instead of using red for my 50-day moving average, because the candles are red, I made purple. And then orange for my 200-day moving average. So that's just how I like to color scheme my moving averages. Now, here are my indicators that I like to use, and I'll explain why I use each. All right. So my indicators are, first one I'm going to put down is called the MACD, which stands for moving, average, converge, and diverge. The one with the star, I'm going to click MACD, right? I'm going to show you how I color scheme the MACD. So this is how I color scheme my MACD. I'm going to click on this plus sign in the top left-hand corner, click the gear on the MACD, and I want my fast MACD line to be a green color, right? So yeah, I want that line to be a green color. And I'm going to explain why. And then I want my slow MACD line to be this purple color down here that I created. Make it kind of thick. And bam, right? So that's how I like my MACD. And I kind of get that color scheme from Hulk, you know, comic book character, Marvel, Hulk. You know, MACD is my strongest indicator, so I like Hulk colors on my MACD, right? So I'm going to go to indicators again, and I'm going to do, which is my next favorite indicator, which is the RSI, which stands for Relative Strength Index. So you're going to click Relative Strength Index right here, right? And I'm going to customize my RSI from scratch. So I want my RSI to be yellow, right? And I want it to be visible, right? And then the top ones, I like, let's see, I can, you know, kind of spice it up. I'll take, what about this color? Like a light blue. Oh yeah, I know, I remember. Okay. My top one, which is over bought, right? I'm going to make that one red. So that way I know it's time to sell when it's near that red line. And then my lower one, which is oversold, I'm going to make green, because that means it's time to buy when it's in that area. So I like it to be a green color. All right, there we go. Bam, it's a green color now. So, you know, I set up these for a reason, just like that, right? And I leave all my indicators standard except one, and I'll explain why later. Next, we're going to have the on-balance volume, right? And this is my last indicator from the one that's on the bottom. So it's all the way down. It's called the OBV, on balance volume. Right? So I'm going to leave that one an orange color. Sometimes I leave it blue. Sometimes I leave it orange. But this time I'll leave it blue. Blue for Nipsey Hussle. Late Nipsey Hussle. Alright? But I do like orange for some reason. It just pops out. You know, I got Nip on my welcome channel, so I'll do orange. Alright, so bam. That's my setup so far. So now let's go to the next indicator, which is Bollinger Bands. Alright? Some people leave it at 20. I don't. I personally set it to 10 so that I can see the breakouts quicker, right? So I set my Belanger bands to 10 now. Now, some people leave it standard at 20. You know, I've been doing it for a little bit, so I leave it at 10. And I like my top and bottom ones to stick out a little bit so I can see what I'm buying. So I can see the Belanger bands, right? They don't have to stick out that much. Let me make it not so visible. Because they're kind of important, but not that important. They're only important to me during day trades. Day trading. Which is another video of mine. Okay. So, bam. We have our setup, right? And how I'm toggling this is I'm pinching it to make it go up, and I'm using my finger or mouse and clicking these numbers on the right hand side to make it pop up like this. And when you pinch it like this, the whole chart moves with it, right? So bam, and you can move these down to kind of, you know, finesse the chart how you want it, to make the top bigger or whatnot. So bam, I have my whole screen set up to the way I want it, right? And that's how I set up my screen. Now, is there others? Okay, during intraday, if I can go to the 5-minute chart. So I went to the 5-minute chart. And I forgot one more important one. We're going to go back to the daily. All right. So we're going to go back to the daily. Your pivot points are important. All right. So my pivot points is so many things that I use. Pivot point standard, right? And you're going to edit your pivot points to not show historical data. I personally don't like historical data on. I just want to see the next pivot points available. I like my pivot points to be a certain color. Not usually doing this baby blue color. So let me change them all to baby blue. Baby blue. Baby blue. So now all my pivot points are baby blue, and make them a little thicker to see, because they are important support and resistances. Very underrated support and resistances. By the way, shout out to everybody who uses them. I kind of brought this back and made it hot on the market. Ask about me. All right. Pivot points are important to me. Use those. So, let me see. Is there any other indicator that I use that I missed out? Pivot points are. So, okay. We got intraday. I'm going to go to the 5-minute chart and see how I got my pivot points on there too. You see how pivot points, support resistances matter? See how it bounced off the pivot point right there? If I was to show it on a brush, look at that. Bounce right off the pivot point right there. It's just that simple. Pivot points are just excellent indicators. So, I want to set up the VWAP, which is volume weighted something. Just know it's VWAP. All right. Volume weighted average price. I think that's what it's called. Yeah, VWAP. All right. As you can see, I'm very educated on these things. I don't, you know. Let me put a star right there because I like the VWAP. I used to not like it, by the way. So I'm going to edit the VWAP. And I'm going to make it white. And I'm going to change it to like this cross type thing. just to make it very visible, because you want to keep an eye on the VWAP and you want to make it a little not too thick. Yeah, about right there, right? So while you trading during the intraday, you want that VWAP to be prevalent at all times, right? So that's the gist of how I set up everything and how it looks. So let's talk about bullish and bearish divergence. So off the top of my head, we can go to FedEx. So we're going to go back on the daily chart. And we're going to go to, and I'm going to edit these and make it kind of visible, because these things can get hectic, right? So I'm going to search FedEx. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these and I'm going to place them right here and make an arrow. And what I do is at the top, you'll see this icon right here. And I just type arrow right there, right? And I'm going to do that again for all of them. So I go to trend line on the top right hand corner, drag it near where it is. Bam. Right. And then do that one more time with these. And I'm going to show you the significance of this, right? Bam. So notice, as, let me get my brush. So this is going down, right? You know what? I'm going to just screenshot and do it that way. That's way better. Okay. So notice, as this going down, the indicators are pointing up, right? And notice what happened. Next three candles were bullish. This is called bullish divergence. So if the stock is pointing down, but the indicators are pointing up, it's called bullish divergence. So what I do is I put the arrows to make it easily visible for me, right? So the stock is going down and the others are pointing up. And that's how you know bullish divergence. Pretty simple, right? And what you do is, it's making the see the stock made a lower low, right? But the indicators made a higher low, right? So that's how you know it's bullish divergence. Now let's go to bearish divergence. If I can remember off the top of my head, I was thinking SPY. Yep, perfect. So I'm going to do bearish divergence. Just follow me. Just follow my pink arrows. So from the top of my head, SPY made a higher high, right? But the stocks made, on the same time frame, a lower low, right? And it did it on all three indicators, right? So this is called bearish divergence. So if the stock makes a higher high, but all three indicators or even a few indicators point down and make a lower high. My fault, I made a lower high. That's bearish divergence. Look what happened. Prices drop. Bearish divergence. It's that simple, right? So these are tools that I use to predict the future, and these are called leading indicators divergences. You need those. Anything else off the top of my head? It's a lot that I use, but these are the basics that you guys need to understand. I am Aristotle. This is a quick video. I winged it. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you guys learned a lot. Let me know what you think. This is exclusively for my chat, so you guys enjoy, and good night. Good trading.